Hello everyone. In this session we are going to see a problem of a Turing machine. Okay, a Turing machine is a mathematical model of an automata that contains an infinite T as a memory unit. Okay, and here we are going to discuss about the problem a power n, b power n, and c power n. That is n number of a's followed by n number of b's followed by n number of c's. Okay, whenever an input string that is made up of this structure, the Turing machine has to go to an accepting state. In case if it doesn't belong to this structure, the Turing machine has to reject the input. Okay, so here we are going to construct a Turing machine that accepts the language L. L is made up of the string a power n, b power n, c power n, and n value is greater than or equal to 1. And here it is over the alphabet A, B, C. So the input is made up of the combination of A, B, C. And the strings are of the form n number of A's followed by n number of B's followed by n number of C's. Okay. And here the n value is greater than or equal to 1. So the minimum value that the n takes is 1. Okay. So that is the input string here contains some set of, when n value is equal to 1, we have 1a, 1b, 1c. Okay, and when n value is equal to 2, we have 2a's followed by 2b's followed by 2c's, and it goes on. And n value is equal to 3, we have 3a, 3b, 3c. Okay, so this, whenever input of this kind, okay, when you give an input and from this set, the Turing machine has to go to an accepting state. Okay, so here the Turing machine contains a infinite tape, a tape structure like this. Okay, and the tape is splitted into cells. Okay, each cell is capable of storing a single alphabet at a time. Okay, we can consider any input, n number of A's and n number of B's and n number of C's. Okay. And the remaining space in the Turing machine, like the tape we consider here, is sealed at this leftmost side. Okay, the leftmost side of the tape, we are going to have it as a finite length. And the rightmost side is infinite. Okay, so after writing the input, you may have some blank spaces in the tape. We are going to use some symbols like this or a B symbol to represent the blank representation. Okay, we are just going to assume that all the blank spaces of the tape contains this symbol. Okay, this denotes that the tape is empty after this. Okay, so whenever we are starting a Turing machine, the input is written from left to right. Okay, and we have a read-write head that focuses on the first element, and the transition always starts with the starting state. Okay, so these are the assumptions that we are going to consider while constructing a Turing machine. Okay, so whenever we are going to start a Turing machine, the input symbol is written from left to right. Okay, and we are going to consider this leftmost edge of the tape as a sealed one. And we are going to have a read-write head that focuses on the first element. And the transition starts with the starting state Q0. Okay, so the idea here is like in for the construction of this Turing machine, the basic idea for the construction of Turing machine here is like the input is made up of A, B and C. Okay, that means equal number of A's, equal number of B's and equal number of C's. Okay, so we can have a loop where whenever we are cancelling, we can cancel one A and we just keep on moving right, and when we find a B, cancel that B and again keep on moving right and cancel one C. Okay, so this is your first loop. Cancel 1A, 1B, 1C, and again come back, take next A, next B, next C. So this loop is iterated for n number of times. Okay, so at the end, if all the A's are cancelled, then all the B's and all the C's should be cancelled off. Okay, so that is the logic behind this. So first in Q0, the input is always, you have the minimum input as A, B, C. At least one A will be there. Okay, so for that, 1A will have 1B and 1C. Okay, so in Q0, we start the transition here with input as A. Okay, so whenever in Q0, in Q0, whenever the input is A, we are going to cancel A. Okay, cancellation in the sense like we are going to use a different symbol for cancelling it. Input A is cancelled to a new symbol, like we consider a new symbol X for cancelling A. Okay, like in order to make the difference between the cancellation of A, B and C, we can use new symbols as I cancel A with X, B with Y and C with Z. Okay, so these symbols are up to the user to take. Okay, so here I cancel A with X and move right until I found a B. Okay, so Q0, one A is cancelled. Okay, as per our procedure, we should have equal number of A, B and C. When one A is cancelled, we have a corresponding B and C for it. So, we have to move right until we found a B. Okay, so right side movement, we can have some N number of A's in between. So, we are making a self loop in this Q1 state. Whenever you have this A in tape, we just keep on moving right. Okay, the tape remains as it is. Once we found the B, we are going to cancel B. Until then, the tape will keep on moving. Okay, so now after in Q1, once we got this B, we are going for a next cancellation. Okay, we are going to cancel B with a new symbol Y. And again, for 1A, 1B is cancelled. And again, we have to cancel 1C. Okay, so we just move right. Okay, so here, again, we have the same step, like after cancelling this B, until the C, we have to keep on moving right side, okay? So, in between, there is a possibility of getting some Bs inside, okay? So, in this self loop, how much ever B comes, we just keep on moving right. And once we got a C, we are going to cancel this C. After each cancellation, it is always preferable to make a state change. Okay, so in Q2, when the input is C, you're going to cancel the C to a new symbol Z. Okay, so for 1A, 1B, 1C has been cancelled. Okay, so this is your first loop. Okay, 1A, 1B, 1C is cancelled. So again, we are going to repeat the same process. Okay, so we have to come back and take the next A. Okay, so here after cancelling the C, okay, 1A, 1B, 1C is cancelled. I have to come back to take the next input. Okay, so while coming back, I can use this left side move. Till now, we are moving right. Okay, each step, we are just moving right, right, right. Now, after cancelling C, I have to come back. While coming back, we have to use this left side move. Okay, so here, while coming back, we have to come back till this cancelled A. Okay, so once in order to denote the next input, if I cancel this A with X, first loop, B with Y and C with Z, okay, after cancelling this C, I have to come back till this A, okay, I have to come back till this A, then only we can know that this is the next input that we want to process, okay, so in order to make the consideration, like we have to keep on moving this left, left, left until we reach this X. And once we reach the X, the next right side element will be the next input that we want to process. Okay. So while coming back, okay, while coming back after this cancellation, we can have some Z, that is the cancelled C's, or we can have some B, or we can have some Y, or we can have some A. In all the cases, like while coming back, the tape is going to remain the same. Okay, till this X, we are just going to make this left move. So, we can have some Z or B or Y or A. In all the cases, I just keep on moving left, left, left until I reach this X. X is the cancelled A. So, once I reach the X, I have to make a right side move to take the next input. Okay, so after taking the next input, again we are going to repeat the same procedure. For this A, we have to cancel 1B, 1C. Okay, so this is an iterated loop. In order to mention this iteration, the cancellation of A is done in this Q0 state. Okay, so I can direct this Q3 transition to Q0 whenever we reach this X input. Okay, in Q3, when we reach the X, you are going to make a right side move and we are going to take the next input in the state Q0. Okay, so again we are going to proceed the same. This A will be cancelled to X. This A will be cancelled to X. And we are going to make a right side move. Okay, and we are going to move right until we found a B. So that is done in this Q1. Okay, now listen, while coming to this Q1 we have a self loop for all A's. And similarly, there might be some Y also, like some already cancelled B also will be there. So we should not stop here. Even if you have this Y, we have to keep right. And once we found a B, we have to cancel this B to Y. And again, we have to make a right side move. And we are just keep on moving until we found a C. Okay, so while coming back, we can have some Z over here that is done in this Q2. Okay, so Q2, for all the B's that are present inside, we are going to make this right side move. And we may have some Z also in between. Okay, so these Z are already cancelled Z. Even if you have this Z, we just keep on moving right. And once we found a C, we are going to cancel that C to Z and we are going to make a left side move. Okay, so second A, B and C is cancelled. So this process is iterated. Okay, so this is repeated for n number of times. And the stopping criteria here is when all the A's are cancelled. Okay, consider all the A's are cancelled in Q3. After cancelling the last Z, last C, we'll come back till this X. Okay, till this portion of X will come back. And once we reach the X, we are going to make a right side move. See here, we have written. Once we reach X in this Q3, you're going to make a right side move and we are going to go for the state Q0. Okay, so in Q0, if the input is Y, that means that all the inputs are cancelled. All the A's are cancelled. Okay, so that means that all A's are cancelled. Now we have to check whether all B and all C's are cancelled off. Okay, so in order to make that verification, we are going to have one more state over here. Okay, consider it as Q4. Okay, that comes when all the A's are cancelled. The Q0 contains some Y here. Okay, in Q0, if you have this transition as Y, we are going to make a right side move. Okay, we are going to verify whether all the B and all the C's are cancelled off. Okay, so for that verification, we are going to have a new state Q4. In Q4, we are going to have a self loop condition. Okay, so we are going to verify whether all the symbols that are there in the tape will be either Y or Z. Y means it is a cancelled B. Z means it is a cancelled C. Okay, so here in Q4, we are going to check whether it is all Y's and Z. So when it is Y or Z, we just keep on moving right. And finally, if we reach the blank symbol, it means that all inputs are cancelled. And in tape, we just have this Y and Z. All X, Y, Z alone in the tape. Okay, so that is a condition where we have equal number of A, B and C. Okay, so here when all the, reaching this Y, okay, if we have just Y and Z, it means that everything in the tape is cancelled off. So we are going to check if in Q4, if we arrive the blank symbol, we are going for this Q accept state. Q accepting is a final state. Whenever the input is correct, whenever the input is proper, we are going for this Q accepting state. Okay. Okay, so this is a Turing machine that works when the input contains equal number of A, B and C. Okay, so now acceptance criteria is properly defined. Similarly, we have to define the rejection criteria also. Already the diagram is complicated. So rejection, we can better just write it separately over here. Okay, I write the rejection states over here. The possible rejection states are okay, so in this Turing machine, as you know, like the Turing machine has a special accepting and rejection state. Whenever a Turing machine enter into the accepting state, the input will be accepted. And similarly, whenever the input is, the tape enters to the rejection state, the input will be rejected. In both the cases, Turing machine will stop. Okay, so whenever we feel that the input doesn't belongs to the belongs to the category, you're going to make a rejection. Okay, so see here in Q4 is the place where all the A's are cancelled. Okay, so in Q4, if you have any remaining B or C, then it means that we have some extra B or C over here. So in that case, we have to make a rejection. Okay, so here in transition of Q4, when the input is B or C. Okay, Q4 always contain Y and Z. In case if it has an B or C, we are going for this Q reject state. Q reject. After rejection, movement of left or right doesn't matter. Okay, and similarly, this is one case when we have extra B or C. Okay, so there is a possibility that the input may contain some extra A. Okay, in that case, one A will be cancelled, but correspondingly, you don't have a B for it. Okay, so in that case, what happened? We can have a transition on Q1. We don't have a B, so it directly goes to Z or C. Okay, in the Q1, if the input is Z or C, you're going to make a rejection state. Okay. And one more category, we can have equal number of A, equal number of B, but there will not be any enough C for it. So in Q2, if it doesn't have any C, it directs to the null state. Okay, in all the category, we are going for a rejection state. Okay, so there are n possible rejection state. These are all the few rejection state that usually occur. Okay, so I had just mentioned these alone. Okay, so when this transition diagram along with the rejection state is done, the problem is